all love reading storybooks. Every story is framed with sentences, and sentences are framed using words. And what are words made up of? They are made up of letters. If you notice, then everything around us is made up of one or the other smaller entity. These small entities are called basic units. Did you know that even our body is made up of basic units? Yes, it is. Although it appears to be one single body, it's actually made up of millions of basic units coming together. What are these units called? They are known as cells. Cells come in different numbers to form a body, rather, any living organism's body. Can you guess the minimum number of cells required to form an organism's body? Do you know the answer? There are organisms which are made up of only a single cell. They are called the unicellular organisms. Bacteria are one of the best examples of this category. What are organisms like us called then? We belong to the category of multicellular organisms. Those having several cells to make up the body are called multicellular organisms. Now, the next important question is, if there are so many cells in our body, then are all of them exactly the same? Of course not. There are many number of cells in our body, and so are their types. Look at these cells, for example. These look so different. But astonishingly, all three are a part of our body. This one is an ovum, this is a neuron, and the last one is a red blood cell. Their structures, shapes, sizes are totally different from each other, and so are their functions. This is how various types of cells come together in different numbers to form our body. We have this knowledge today, but ever wondered how all this was actually discovered? Let us go back in time and have a look at the history of cellular studies.